Well, hello, my friends. Today, this is about Technics VU meters. Yeah, so Technics power amplifiers with VU meters, with huge VU meters. And this is part two. Yeah, in part one, I showed you, you have to go back to that video, that those smaller Technics amplifiers. They ask now so much money for, they are not worth buying, and not worth buying not because of the looks, but because sound wise it's not worth spending so much money for just two nice VU meters, because the sound will disappoint you. But there are Technics devices with a good sound, with even more beautiful VU meters than those cheaper SAA1000, SAA1010, SAA900, etc. Those cheaper series with those plastic fronts. Stay away from those cheaper series with those plastic fronts. Yeah. So all these Technics power amplifiers I'm going to discuss today, they are all very expensive. So that's why I make this part separate, because it is another leak. How much do you want to invest in your stereo setup? You know, do you think it's worth spending 2,000 euro and more? Because we are talking about 2,000 euro devices and more. So the complete pre and main, and I'm going to show you which one are in that price class, but all of them are pretty nice sounding. The SAA70, yeah, that's this one, yeah, and it's a very nice looking device. But this one you won't see very often. It is a very rare thing. Yeah, here you see it in a stack with the matching pre-amplifier. Beautiful. It have 160 watt a channel, and it have a weight from 20 kilo. Serious stuff, my friend, serious stuff. Here we see some prices. The complete set 1900 euro. The power amp 800. 2000. Oh, this have to be a mistake, I think. 1400 euro for the complete set. This is all in this year, 2021. So well, this is these are the prices I can find. Yeah, around between 1500 and 2000 euro for the complete set, the SAA70. Not that expensive if you compare it with that first video where they asked for a 1010, also 1500, but that sound is worthless. It was only 2x70 watt. This is a beast. This is a beast from 2x160 watt. And then if you compare that with that 1010 where they ask 1500 for, then 2000 is not expensive. Yeah, but okay, maybe you're lucky, maybe you can score a set like this for 1500 euro, then you're lucky. So it's not that expensive. Another beast is this Technics SA2000. It came out in 1993, and this thing, even if it have only 100 watts a channel, it is 22 kilo. So serious stuff, my friend, serious stuff. And this is how it is looking. You know, you have to watch for yourself, go on Google and to see which device fitted you most, which one, because all of them have different VU meters. You know, which style do you like the best? And I'm just hinting you here, this is the inside, this is the inside of that 2x100 watt device. It is a very serious build, nice building quality, beautiful. Here we have another picture. I think this is the Japanese version, yeah, from the SA-8-2000. Beautiful, beautiful, with those wooden blocks on the side. And also like this pre-amplifier. Beautiful stuff, my friends. So this is the Japanese SA-2000. Yeah, you can see it over here. Not sure how much the price this is, slotty. And then there is this SAA-3000, also 100 watt, but built from 1998 till 2003. So 25.6 kilo. Unbelievable, beautiful. Yeah. 48 centimeters wide. Beautiful stuff. And what I also like is that pre-amplifier. I think it looks a little bit like those Marantz PM17 amplifiers. I had one, and it had a temperature meter. I think also this one have a temperature meter. Not sure what this meter is. I think it's for the temperature. Never knew of the existence of this pre-amplifier, but probably Marantz stole that ID from Technics, or Technics stole that ID from Marantz. Not sure who stole from who. We had that war, that audio war, who made the best stuff in between 1970 and 1980. And when you saw these huge VU meters, they came in the world after the tuner went digital. So in 1980, we had the first digital tuners. And from that moment on, audio stuff was looking a little bit boring. You know, I mean, a radio at that period was still an important device. A tuner was still a important thing from a stereo setup. So when that analog, that beautiful analog tuner went away for only those digital numbers, they came up with VU meters. Because a VU meter is nothing else as a measuring device for the studios. Yeah, and they were used up till late 80s. Yeah, maybe there's still some studios using or working with VU meters, not sure. But they implanted those VU meters in those power amps. Brands like Onkyo, Yamaha, Denon, Technics. Suddenly they all start making power amps with huge VU meters. The bigger, the better. It is interesting to see that suddenly it started around 1980. Yeah, and those huge VU meters were implanted for 20 years. For 20 years you could see high-end stereo devices with huge VU meters. And then suddenly it was gone. You only saw them with Macintosh or Acuphase. Some brands still had them, but most brands stopped with those VU meters. Not sure why. Not sure why, but lately they returned because many brands discovered that people still like these VU meters in their stuff because it gives your setup a special dimension. I mean, it is lighted instead of only black, yeah, or only silver. With a few lamps, those VU meters made your set look more expensive. Let's be honest. I mean, and Technics was very good in building. They built those VU meters in the cheaper series and in the more expensive series. And they made many. So I cannot show you everything, but this SUA-7C-7000 was one of them. Beautiful, beautiful inside building also. And I love that pre-amplifier. Beautiful. If I could ever score a set like this, This would be my main set, my friends. My main setup, really. But okay, what more did Technics had? Well, I show you this SA3000. I already showed you that. You had this SA3, yeah. And I had the SAA5, but that's a completely different series. This 1987, and it had 200 kilo or 200 watt the channel with 35 kilo, an impressive 35 kilo. This was something, eh? And I think it is pretty rare, this SAA3. All these devices, so this is the inside of a Technics SAA3, and you can see these two huge travos. I'm not sure if they had two separate power cables, but this is unbelievable stuff, my friends. Unbelievable stuff. If you see this, then you know it is quality. Yeah, what I showed you in that first video, those cheaper Technics with that lousy building quality, this is some different stuff, my friends. This is something completely different. And well, what more they show about this thing? Well, nothing special, only a few pictures, but it is beautiful. And the 2x200 watt is very powerful. So you had more. This is the SAA5000, built from 1990, 170 watt the channel, with a weight of 34 kilo, and also that is incredible. I mean, that's an incredible device. All these devices were beautiful. And well, I see here an Onkyo M10, but that is for another video. This is, I think, everybody who is watching this video now, yeah, you're still watching, then you know that when you can ever score, when you ever can score a Technics like this, I mean, it is just unbelievable. This is just incredible stuff, my friends. This is the best Onkyo ever made. This is really the best Onkyo ever made. But okay, that is for another story, another. You know, I'm gonna make the Onkyo like I did now for the two videos from the Technics. I'm gonna make that from Onkyo also. But okay, what is more beautiful? You know, which Technics is the most beautiful one? Hard to tell, my friends. Hard to say. I mean, if I click here, Technics, they are all beautiful. They are all beautiful. And I mean, yeah, as you can see, these VU meters look completely different than these VU meters. The problem what I often have with VU meters, that if you see a picture like this, yeah, the dial pointers, so the VU meters, yeah, the VU pointers, they are very small. You hardly can see them. So if you are sitting from 4 or 5 meter distance, you won't see all. You will only see lightning, yeah. And as you can see, these are a little bit thicker, yeah. And if I see this picture, then I love more this design than the design I just showed you, where you can hardly see the difference between, well, if you're sitting from a huge distance, from 3, 4, 5 meter distance, you want to see the movement from the needle in those VU meters. And yeah. And that was something from the past. They made that mistake, but I see that still in modern hi-fi equipment, they still make the mistake that they make those VU, these needles too little, you know. So you have to sit close and to see what is happening from a few meters distance you won't see it anymore, or maybe my eyes are getting old. This is also a possibility, you know. You can see that in this Technics SU series, the SUC7700, you can see that they are much clearer also from a long distance, you know. They use thicker material for the needle, because if you see a picture like this, it is hard to say where the needle is. So, but you have to watch all those Technics devices. If you like Technics, well, you do not even have to like the brand. To be honest, I do not like the brand Technics, but I mean, with a amp like this, the SA7000 of the SA2000, you can't go wrong. They are power amps, and I just showed you the inside. It is all serious built, so I cannot believe that these things will sound. This is bad sounding stuff. The SA9000, that's very bad sounding stuff, my friends. Yeah, this is bad, and this is bad sounding stuff. This one, the SA1000, that's all bad sounding stuff. I advise not to buy, yeah? But all of this stuff, this SA2000, SA7000, yeah, SAA100, all of them, this is the SA5000, all of them, if I could score them for a reasonable price in the Netherlands, all of them, including the preamp, because I would never buy only the power amp, because then you have to look for a preamp. You're not sure how long that will take before you find one. So I want the complete set. No complete set, no buy, no deal. And all of these Technics, one of them, all of them are piece by piece are beauties. And now they have this thing, this monster. It have a price from €13,000, and the preamp have the same price, so you have to pay €25,000 for the set. It is 2x150 watt and a weight from 54 kilo. That's the newest Technics SER1 that came out in 2014, and still they make the mistake, as you can see, that I think they should have learned from the past. I love this amp, I like this amp, I like the looks from this amp, probably the sound is fantastic. But why did they make these VU meters so hard to read? I think they could use some thicker lines. That's my idea, you know. That's my idea. Or even better, lightning from behind, so you can see the lightning stripes. Yeah, but that is of course more expensive to make, yeah. And this SAR1, it is a beauty. This is pound, English pound, so the pound is more expensive than the euro, yeah. That's why it is £12,000. Anyway, if I see this, yeah, this one, and I compare it with this one, for example, I think this one is the more beautiful one with the wooden side blocks. Beautiful stuff, my friends. I think if I had the choice, I would go for this one. I would go for this one. Let me see how much they ask for this set. Let me see. €8,000. Unbelievable. And it have a shipping weight from 100 kilo. Well, there's a lot of money. Well, no, wait a minute. 8,000 Canadian, this is about €5,500. Okay. Not that I'm going to pay it. No. But Maybe I'm lucky. Maybe I one day can score a set like this for 2,000-3,000 euro. And that would be fantastic. Because if you have a set like this, you are finished with hunting, you know, because you know you have one of the most beautiful sets ever built. Let's be honest. I mean, watch these pictures. Unbelievable. And this temperature meter, yeah, this is a temperature meter. This beautiful, beautiful, beautiful stuff. Like these VU meters were not enough. Yeah, they place an extra temperature meter. Well, so this is the end of the Technic story, my friends. I mean, I can talk hours and hours from. I mean, I can take every model separate, talk about that model, you know. But it is up to you. It is up to you how much you want to spend for your stereo set. Yeah, it is expensive stuff. But guys, you only live once. You only live once, so, you know, and if this is the stuff you like, I mean, it is beautiful and it will make you happy. It will make you happy. In the end, if you have something like this, doesn't matter if it's from Technic, from Onkyo, from Denon, Yamaha, this is the stuff you want. This is the stuff we all want, but yeah. You know, we keep it with the lower end stuff. You know, this is super high end. I mean, this was the high end from the 90s, yeah. And it is beautiful stuff. I mean, if I compare modern high end, I think why they do not make that this stuff today like 20 years ago. You know, they could make it 20 years ago, so they can make it now, but is it too expensive? Is it? I'm not sure why. You know, because I see many new devices. Even if you compare this device with the most modern device, I mean this thing, I mean, yeah. For me, it is a nice looking amplifier. Of course, I would want to have one. But if you compare the looks from this one with this one, then I choose for this one. So for the looks. Yeah, for the looks. I mean, so this one is 20 years older. So they can still make them. But not sure why they choose for making boring stuff these days. Not sure. Not sure. This thing even have a, as you can see on the sides, between the wooden blocks, it have some gold stuff here. It's unbelievable. How much time and design they put in these things. Yeah, the designers did a better job, yeah, in the 90s, in the 80s and the 90s than they do now. I believe, because when I see, you know, okay, from Macintosh, I would say the newer Macintoshes are more beautiful than the older Macintoshes. But yeah, if you see Denon amplifiers these days, and you see the Denon power amplifiers in the past, give me the old power amps than the new power amps, because I prefer the older ones, more beautiful. Same counts for Onkyo. Yeah, so not sure why they stopped making these beautiful devices. Anyway, this was my second topic, the second part of Technics, yeah, just to show you that if you have money to spend, if you want to spend money, maybe you are doubting, you think, okay, this thing is more important than... And to be honest, it is the same like buying a car. I mean, if you go to the dealer, you say, okay, I want this car, but I want it with 17-inch wheels and et cetera, et cetera. I mean, the engine is still the same, the engine, yeah? It will not go drive faster because of your 17-inch wheels or other stuff like you put on that car. That you know, but it will cost you more in the end. And same counts for this stuff. I mean, probably there are even better sounding Technics without VU meters. Yeah, but people do not want that stuff. People want a Technics or a Onkyo. Or Denon, doesn't matter, Yamaha from the past, you know, from the 80s, high end from the 80s and the 90s, but they want them with VU meters. Yeah, that makes them double, sometimes three double more expensive as that same amplifier from that same brand, yeah, but without VU meters. And yeah, I mean, if this amplifier was just a straight amplifier without VU meters, then the price would be, let's say that this thing costs 3,000 euro, then the price from that other amp will be 1,000 euro. So for only the VU meters, you pay 2,000 euro. But this is the reality. I cannot change that. This is what people want to pay for these VU meters. They want to pay 3 times as much the sound quality. This is it, my friends. And I'm one of them. I'm one of them. So, not sure which one is more beautiful. This thing of my recently bought Pioneer SX1250. It is still upstairs, my friends. Because I think I first want to bring that Pioneer SX1250 to John to check it out if everything is still okay, you know, before I start using the thing. I'm not planning to sell that thing. No, not in the coming few years, you know. Maybe when the price of the Technics maybe if the price of that Pioneer SX1250 reach a price from 2,500, 3,000 euro, maybe at that time I'm gonna sell it, but not now, no. And that SX950 I will also bring to John. That's why they are still upstairs in my hallway. A few other amplifiers, that Sunsree AU919. Nick is still waiting for the answer. And yeah, you're all curious, also me. I bought many things lately, yeah. And since I bought that Denon POA 1500 with those huge VU meters, I am suddenly into huge VU meters. I previously had that Onkyo M504, was not very happy with the sound, that's why I sold it. First I waited until Simon completely revised his M504. I asked him, okay, what's the sound now? And then he told me, no, it is still not better as the Sunsweet and that Aquiphase. And so I think, okay, not for me. No, I want to have a nice big VU meter set, but with minimum the sound of the Sunsweet or the Aquiphase. And yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe that Denon POA 1500 I just bought have that quality, but I'm not sure about that. You will all see that in the coming videos on this channel. Thanks for watching. Put the thumbs up if you like the video. And for now I say ciao.